Hello, everybody, and welcome to SKL Week 2, Day 4. It's the first day of March Madness, but we're looking to get mad here in SKL as well. My name is Kevin Big Booty Bodie, and with me tonight, I have got the one and only Peter Crafty Buckeye McKay.
Yeah, it's looking like some teams are going to need some luck of the Irish on this one.
Some luck of the Irish here on St. Patrick's Day. Happy St. Patrick's Day, Crafty.
Thank you.
Do you celebrate? Are you Irish?
No.
Me neither.
Neither.
Skillos, are you Irish? All right, Skillos is Irish.
Confirmed Irish.
Happy St. Patrick's Day to Skillos. But we have got a great game here for you tonight, folks. Perhaps the match of the week, you could even call it. We've got Argonne 53 throwing down against Team Malicious Intent.
Whipping into these bands, though, They even threw in a Kale. Shen, Graves, and Kale by Argonne 53.
Very interesting. Shen is a favorite champion of Mo Money.
That makes sense.
Yeah, like we know that. Graves, generally strong. What about the Kale, though?
Kale? I don't know if that's like a jungle, like, priority. Like, it could go mid, it could go three lanes, but like, I don't know whose specialty it is, but it's definitely a target.
Yeah, it must be against someone. And then on the other side for Team Malicious Intent, we have Lulu, Gragas, and Braum,
and that really hypes up the Alistar in the meta right now. He's really the only strong, especially Mo Money, contested pick for him without the Shen up and the Braum gone.
Yeah, Alistar
and Lulu as well, because he likes to play that support. So I honestly I'm not sure what he will play. It could honestly be the Nautilus support, but that could also be flex because they have played it top. And honestly, they played Silent mid last week. They could play Nautilus mid too.
They could certainly play anything. We've got, for Team Malicious Intent, we have Coach DXI Edge doing their picks and bans. So we'll have to see what he comes up with.
TMI Edge now? I don't know. That's what his Twitter handle changed to.
TMI DXI Edge? Yeah, I don't know.
I don't know. Who cares?
Former jungler for Indecision from last year.
We got some former
year.
Teammates going up against each other. Yes. Weeblet taking on Similodon and Tough Guy.
His former bot lane partner.
Yeah. Oh, wow. They know each other's strats.
Yeah, they do.
So maybe that'll into here.
It could. No bad blood there, though. They're still friends. Oh, Weeblet initially didn't want to play in SKL again this season. Then he kind of decided last minute that he did. So he hopped onto a team here on Argonne 53, and they qualified. So they've been looking good so far.
They've shown some success. Yep. And what was their series last week?
They went 1-1 against Fellowship.
Yeah, they played definitely a strong game one. I thought they were almost going to 2-0 them. Mm-hmm. And maybe just a couple misplays. They got outscaled, but they still are a team to fight with, and this game is definitely the match of the week for this week.
Absolutely, yeah. Two big teams here. So for the second rotation coming in, blue side here, Argonne 53, they pick up the Elise and Gangplank. Also two very strong picks in the meta right now. That Gangplank, that could go top or mid. What do you think of those two picks here, Crafty?
I would assume top at this point.
Yeah, okay.
But right. I don't honestly, Dark Creation played some not usual mid lane champions like Katarina, Yasuo. So
yeah,
he could play this. I honestly have no idea. But it's just a strong pick. So lots of late game right there.
Absolutely.
Yeah. But Fiora is also up on the board, so that's pretty scary.
Yeah, that could go. They could pick to take Fiora, put her top, and then they could put that Nautilus at support. Actually, you could even put Nautilus mid. But Dark Creation, he just came in last week for Argonne 53, was not the mid laner that played through qualifiers for Argonne 53. Nubinator was actually in the mid laner, but then they had a bit of a roster swap. Nubinator moved to the top lane, and now Dark Creation coming in the mid lane. This is his second week with the team. He showed up pretty well last week, so with even more synergy in this second week, they should be looking for even a better performance out of him.
Yeah, and they show their top mid lane and jungle so far, so they could flex that Nautilus and pick it top. I think that's definitely a rumble on the jungle. I don't think it would be rumble top.
Yeah, that seems to be the most common place for rumbles being picked nowadays.
But so they're saving their last pick for either support or top and just flex that Nautilus, I think, would be the overall game plan. Maybe LeBlanc support.
I
terribly doubt it. You never know. I see it all the time, man.
Yeah.
I'm a LeBlanc support main.
No, you're not.
Yeah, I've never played the champion.
Definitely will be looking to... I'll do a lot of assassination on that LeBlanc. TSM, never lucky. Hopefully looking to get lucky on this St. Patrick's Day here with that LeBlanc.
It's one day he's lucky, maybe... might be this one.
Yeah. So the final rotation being locked in now for Argon 53, Corki and Yasuo. So that most likely it looks like that Gangplank will go top along with Yasuo mid. Again, we did see Dark Creation play that last week against Fellowship of the Nerds. So a champ, definitely a champion he likes to play. You know, late game that could get very scary along with the Gangplank. Late game, this team comp from Argon 53 is going to be doing a lot of damage.
I agree. I almost might expect like a Morgana. I'm not sure. Okay.
All right.
But I feel like that Nautilus will be going top. That's just my opinion, because I feel like Nautilus, if Alistar lands a combo, there's so much burst coming out of that Corki with a Frost Bomb on top of that knockup that it could just like instantly win a 2v2 situation.
That could definitely happen. Yeah. So we'll have to see 3 seconds. Soraka. The Soraka, of course.
Because then if you headbutt Paul, then you just heal that right back up.
Oh, can't stop other Soraka being locked in, so that Nautilus will be going top. I love Soraka. Such just a funny champion to watch, just how absurd the healing is on that champion. And in this new patch, 6.5, did she receive buffs, actually, in this newest patch? Was it?
I think so.
Maybe.
Don't quote us on that.
Don't quote me on it. But I think she might have actually gotten
mildly buffed. It's already a stupid strong champion.
Yeah.
They just might have to... If a Gangplank barrel lands on her, she's going to be really low.
Yes.
In a late game fight, there'll be no heals coming out because she'll be dead.
That's true. That will definitely be a problem. You can't heal when you're dead. Definitely a problem here, but two definitely very strong team comps coming.
Very different,
though. Yeah, very different coming in from both teams here. Just looking at them, they've got a little bit of the meta in them, but then a little bit of flavor as well. You know, the I guess
Rumble, the Yasuo.
Yeah, it's kind of they got a little spicy. Yeah,
I agree. Yeah. I like the team comps a lot.
So do I. Looking at these two team comps here, you know, blue side Argon 53 and red side Team Malicious Intent Crafty. Which are you liking better here going into game one?
I feel like the early game is a lot better from Argon 53. Elise level 3 gank is much stronger than a Rumble level 3 gank.
Yeah.
So if Elise is able to snowball, say, Yasuo or Gangplank, and then maybe they all end up bot for a big team fight with the package there, that could snowball a lead very quickly. So that's why I'm going to go that way for this pick ban.
Okay. Well, I think... Just looking at the two team comps here, you're going with Argon 53. So I think here for game one, I'm going to go with Team Malicious Intent. Just they're going to be doing so much damage. Yeah. You know, the Kalista, the LeBlanc, and, you know, those two squishies, they can go in, do a lot of damage. And if they get chunked out, Soraka comes in, heals them up. They can go back right in, do a bunch more damage. And then you just got Nautilus, tanky.
A Soraka healing a Nautilus is never going to die.
and for how tanky Nautilus gets... the guy still does quite a bit of damage.
I agree, and I'm excited for this one. I think we're going to take a quick break here before game one. We will be right back with game number one between Argon 53 and Malicious Intent. Stick around.
Set, go!
Welcome back, everybody. We're looking to get into game one here between Argon 53 and Team Malicious Intent. On the blue side here for game one, we have got Argon 53. We have A53 Numinator bringing in Gangplank in the top lane, A53 Toast on Elise in the jungle, Dark Creation on that Yasuo mid lane, and Caboose and Weeblet bringing in the Corki Alistar bot lane.
And on the red side, we have Malicious Intent. And in the top lane, Smilodon taking on his former teammate Weeblet. He's not in the same lane, but Smilodon playing his Nautilus. Help Me playing his Rumble. TSM Neverlucky bringing in LeBlanc in the mid lane. And in the bot lane, Lil Tough Guy and Momani with the Kalista Soraka. Apparently, Help Me and Dark Creation didn't get the memos to join the club because they don't have the.
Are they the only two with the club's tags?
One player on each team doesn't have the club.
Oh, rip.
It really looks good, though.
It does. That club is that new feature coming in. There's a mastery pop. If you're playing the SKL drinking game, that is one drink for that mastery pop here on St. Patrick's Day. There's another one. You know, you can command Nightbot with the word drink to show you the rules of the SKL drinking game. Here on St. Patrick's Day might be a good time to play it. But of course, we here at SKL do not in any way condone underage drinking, binge drinking, or drinking while driving. If you are of the legal age, you are more than welcome to have a recreational drink and partake
have a green beer for us.
Partake in the SKL drinking game. Hopefully the players aren't drinking.
I got one with me right now.
Yeah, it's water. Crafty is drinking water. You think the players are drinking right now, Crafty?
No.
No?
You might maybe.
It could help. You never know.
Yeah, loosen up the jitters. It's a big one tonight. Yeah,
this is a big team, especially like we've talked about before, those former teammates. It always makes it, the stakes are always a little higher, even if, you know, as we said, there's no bad blood between teammates, of course, but the stakes are always a little higher, even when you're playing your friends, because you want those bragging rights.
And those... Whenever I play Silky or Xanator, I want to win.
Exactly. You have got to get those bragging rights, because then you can just, you know, you don't let it go. You lord it over them for a while, and it's a lot of fun playing these games between friends.
I agree. And this one, it's bound to be good, so I'm excited for this game. And I think early game definitely lends towards... Argon 53, but until like the late game when Yasuo and Gangplank are just monsters, it kind of might lean towards Malicious Intent, so you might see that mid game be a little stronger. So hopefully Argon 53, to take this, they're gonna need a lead.
Yeah, they are definitely gonna need to get some scaling going, some lanes snowballing. We'll have to see how that goes. There's some trades going back and forth here in all lanes, but nothing too big happening here. No shows for the jungle so far. Crafty, where do you think the junglers are going to make their first appearance here in this game?
Definitely on the upper half of the map, so top or mid.
Okay.
Maybe I doubt bot, just because Soraka. Unless you get the Soraka, there's really no point in ganking, because trading with them and not killing the Kalista would be just the waste of time, because she'll wait 5 seconds and then be full health again.
Exactly. Yeah, so definitely not a very gankable lane here for Toast. So maybe looking to, and you know, that makes sense for him even more to gank mid or top again to get that Yasuo or that Gangplank.
Yeah, I agree. And if Gangplank, especially with a little bit of nerfs that have come in recently, if he can get ahead, then maybe that'll definitely be better against such a strong top laner.
Yeah, and trade going on the mid lane. Dark Creation actually forced a flash out there. Took a shot from the tower. The knockup goes out onto Mo Money, but Caboose has a spear in him. Looks like Toast is there. Repels up and back down. No kills picked up yet, but here comes Help Me, throwing shots back the other way from the rumble, and these two teams will just split off from each other. But it looks like Argon 53 did come out on the better end of that trade.
I would agree. Malicious Intent did win the mid lane trade, just burning Flash.
Yes.
It was a trade of Summoners, Ignite for Flash, but Flash is definitely worth in that case against the Yasuo, especially now really his only escape is to E through you as you come in.
Mm-hmm.
So that I could see Rumble coming in, especially at 6, when he hits level 6. It could be a strong gank there, but you see now Little Tough Guy and Little Money are back to full health after chugging a couple pots and healing each other up.
The ambulance coming in from the Soraka. Slight CS advantage in this bot lane right now on the side of Argon 53, but it's just about negligible. A couple more waves coming in, and it should probably even out unless we see a gank coming down. It will be important to see which side can get ahead, but you know, these two ADCs, Corki and Kalista, once they get to the mid game, you know, they're both going to be doing a lot of damage.
I agree, and I think that, just going back to that first gank, I think that the cocoon lands, they obviously headbutt Paul Soraka. They were trying to focus her down. Cocoon lands on Kalista, and then all of a sudden they just decide to trade focus, but exhaust comes out, and that probably saved them. The focus, if the cocoon lands on Soraka, she's dead, though.
Yeah.
That's first blood, for sure. So it was a good idea to focus her down. It just didn't work out.
Yeah, definitely the right target for them to pick off, and we said, you know, we didn't expect a gank in the bot lane because of the reason of the Soraka, but they did the strategy of trying to take her out, but unfortunately did not work out for them. The next gank, probably, as you were saying, will most likely be Help Me, maybe coming in that mid lane before Dark Creation's flash comes back up. It's still not even halfway back being back up, but Dark Creation doesn't care. He's going in onto TSM Never Lucky on his own, chunking him out quite a bit to below half health, but will just back off for now. Without flash available, he can't really dive too deep.
No, and you see Toast up in that top side of the red side jungle there, so they might be looking to dive, but he was pinged off due to that pink ward in that bush, if you can see it on the mini map there.
Dredge line lands onto Numinator, but he does have a barrel there, and Similodon does not want to walk through that.
Yeah, oh, there's the pink ward. Good. Hey. Good clear of the vision there. Like, that would be when all the fans would be clearing right there, cheering for
them. Oh, I hate when they do that. I don't know. Was that at? That was at IEM. They were doing that,
yeah,
right?
IEM.
Yeah. Oh, so annoying. Every time a ward's cleared, the fans just cheer. I don't know. They think it's funny, but I mostly find it annoying. Looks like Help Me made a brief appearance in the mid lane there, but looks like wasn't able to do anything. Caboose takes a shot there, but just lots of trades going back and forth here. No first blood yet, Crafty.
Nothing, and very even as CS across the board. No real advantages, just slight trading, but Similodon looking like he can take him, and he's, if this Dreadline lands...
Oh, the Dreadline does land! That was about max range, and that's first blood for Similodon. Wow, great solo kill there for the Nautilus.
Especially being down in CS, that definitely helps hype up the 1v1 and gives that gold lead over to Similodon.
Yeah, just showing the fact that, like we were saying, Nautilus, pretty tanky, but, you know, gets those Riptides out, and they can hurt a lot, as we just saw. And Numinator going down on that gangplay, that does not bode well for him. You know, he's looking to snowball that lane and get really ahead.
Yeah, a fed Nautilus is probably, like, the worst thing right now.
Yeah.
Just gonna build that ZZ. Looking like they're gonna...
Cannon Barrage going down, signaling that there might be a gank coming in. Perhaps. There's the combo from Little Tough Guy. Foss Bomb goes down, but the Soraka heal is there. Yeah,
if Elise is there, that would have been like a nice play, but...
Yeah.
Elise was in base right there. I'm not entirely sure what the game plan was there. Who called that? I'm not sure. But,
yeah, interesting. I mean, wanted some damage done, I guess. As Momoney gets knocked back, Caboose gets exhausted, forced to flash, gets knocked up from the Fates Call. The Equalizer comes down, and this will be Caboose going down with Help Me picking up that kill, making it 2-0 right now for Team Malicious Intent.
Betty wishes he had the Cannon Barrage there.
Yeah, no kidding. You would think, just a weird choice of ult there by the Numinator. Maybe he had it, so he wanted to use it, get some damage down. Maybe Caboose and Weeblet thought they had the 2v2 there?
I honestly have no idea. It happened and it's over, but Hopefully we see some better cannon barrages in the near future, but free dragon for Team Malicious Intent. Yes,
dragon number one.
Yeah, not sure if they're looking to stack or not, but it always helps to get the first one down.
Yeah, you know, with the amount of talent between these two teams, they're both very strong. I could see this game going late enough that the dragon stacking could become a factor. You know, yesterday we had Onyxia versus Sasquatches, you know.
Look at how much damage that is.
Yeah, I know. Similadon just chunking out Numinator.
No dredgeline was even used there. It was all just Nautilus's
autos and
Riptides.
Yeah. But as I was saying, you know, that game between Sasquatches and Onyxia, two teams that you kind of know that, you know, the games probably aren't going to be that long. So we weren't really worrying or talking about dragons, but this should be a close series between these two teams. Both very strong, a lot of individually talented players on both sides. So we definitely could see the games go long enough that dragons could become a factor.
I agree 100%. And also with the scaling that comes out of a Yasuo and a Gangplank, it always helps to eliminate that possibility of scaling as well.
Yep.
So, it's just the first one, so maybe we might see a contest for the second one, but you never actually know.
Yeah, you know, dragons really in the early game really not worth fighting over that much, as we see Help Me, making an appearance in the mid lane. The Flame Spitter was there. Equalizer is available, but the Cannon Barrage goes down. Dark Creation and Toast are looking for him. They're able to turn around as Help Me goes down. TSM Neverlucky might be next as Toast rappels down on him. The clones coming out. Will they follow the right one? Neverlucky looks like he will be able to get out of this. But Mo Money and Lil Tough Guy are there to support him. But still, one kill going over to the side of Argon 53.
Help Me doesn't get his equalizer down, and the Soraka ult was a little late. I think if the Soraka ult comes earlier, he's able to drop the equalizer and maybe end up turning that one for one. But in the end, great gank there by Toast, and
the cocoon lands from Toast onto Mo Money, but Weeblet's there, but he's actually pretty low already. Toast gets the kill onto Mo Money, and with no Soraka there to heal, Tough Guy and Similadon might be in a bit of a pickle, as Similadon did teleport down, forces the flash out of Toast. The rend is not going to be enough, but Caboose and Weeblet, they're going for it as Lil Tough Guy goes down. Will Similadon be next? He picks up the kill onto Caboose. Looking to 1v2, he gets the double kill. Is the triple there onto Toast? He got locked up by the cocoon. TSM Neverlucky and Dark Creation have roamed down there now. Help Me coming up in the top lane. Numinator was on that turret, but the Flame Spitter going down. Numinator thought he had that top lane to himself. Dark Creation, he will go down now. That's the third kill Similadon picks up. TSM Neverlucky now flashes, looking to go in onto Toast.
Yep. Oh my god.
Unfortunately,
TSM really Neverlucky.
Not even on St. Patrick's Day. Yeah. Toast very low, but he will get out. That was an unofficial triple kill picked up by Similadon there. Great TP by him.
Oh yeah, and it definitely doesn't help that Nubinator died on the other side of the map, unable to pick up a tower in a response to the no TP from him.
Yeah, definitely not an ideal situation. Choose not to TP, great. The point of that is you
trade an objective.
You trade a tower.
Yeah.
But Help Me was able to get up there. He wasn't needed in the ball lane. He got up there. Numinator must not have expected him to be there.
Yeah.
And Help Me just able to pick up that kill. And this Numinator now two deaths already, but he still is ahead in CS.
Yeah, that's just Gangplank things though, but four kills on Nautilus is a scary thing. All the kills coming through are from Rumble and Nautilus.
Yeah, you might look to get some free. I mean, yeah, that's...
And those are two champions that don't have the earliest kill pressure.
Yeah, you're playing, you've got a Nautilus and a Rumble with six kills between them, and then you've still got a LeBlanc and Kalista just waiting to scale up and get in on the action. So Argon 53, things not looking amazing for them, but they're not in too bad a position. The gold lead isn't that big, as they do have CS leads, small, albeit in some lanes, but
In almost every lane except for jungle.
Yeah, they do. Nubinator ahead, and then Dark Creation, Caboose as well, but they're relatively small. I think no more than 10, but ahead nonetheless, which is kind of mitigating the gold difference from being down in kills for them.
I agree, and I think they are in a position to fight here at Dragon when it does come up in a minute, especially with the no TPs up from Smilodon. I don't think it'll be up in time for a dragon, but Cannon Barrage will be available for that, so that could sway a fight in their favor.
It definitely could, but you've also got to keep in mind. Oh, the dredge line! Those things are just Smilodon is using those things to the fullest, getting the max range out of them possible. He's stretched them out like Michael Jordan in Space Jam at the Space end, you know? Yeah, the dunk.
There's another drink.
Yeah, there's a drink for a movie. Drink for a movie reference if you're playing. But as I was saying, you got to watch out on the side of Team Malicious Intent. They have, you know, Rumble with the Smite, but you also have Kalista, which if she stacks the spears, the Rend, it's basically like having a second, well, kind of like having a second Smite. So you got to always be cautious of that around objectives if you are Argon 53.
Very, very true. It just depends. If they start it, then they might be able to do it, Argon 53, because they won't have the Rend stacks in there quite in time. But it's also scary having just a Soraka on the back line at all times. Yep. In every fight, I just hate it. It's the worst. But I'm not really sure if there will be a fight, because Dragon is live right now, and Smilodon is just beating on Nubinator right now.
Yeah, Nubinator not having a fun time in that top lane. Just this Nautilus is so tanky while still doing so much damage, and being in the early game here, there's really not much that Nubinator can do at this point. He needs to wait a little more, get some more items, scale up before he can start doing more damage back towards Smilodon.
I agree 100%. It looks like Helpme is coming in here for a lane gank, and it hasn't quite been spotted out. They do pink it, so that is kind of like a keying sign that something could happen, because the jungler could just show up in there, so they're not going to really face check. But clearing the vision out and maybe setting up for a dragon here will be Helpme, little tough guy, and more money.
Yeah, it looks like they are going there now, as Weeblet will take out that pink board in that bush. We'll have to
TP.
See.
Both TPs are almost up. Numinator's is like seconds away.
But looks like they're not going to have enough time. The Cannon Barrage not even going to come down for this dragon, it looks like, as it will go down very quickly. That is dragon number two being picked up here for Team Malicious Intent, as Dark Creation gets chunked out a lot by TSM Neverlucky, and there it is, the kill, the solo kill being picked up. Helpme was there, but Neverlucky didn't even need him. Toast gonna be there to defend that tower, but Dark Creation going down, and we're now starting to see just the crazy amount of damage that TSM Neverlucky is going to be doing on that LeBlanc.
And if the Milodon roam down means this is probably going to be that mid lane tower. So picking up objectives off kills, it might not go down, but is always worth.
It is, yeah. Didn't have the minion wave for it to go down, but after picking up that dragon number two, bonus damage, two structures, those towers, will start going down even quicker now.
And here comes a Rift Herald too, that's freeze.
Yeah, the Onyxia coming in. We don't need to call it an Onyxia every time someone gets a Rift Herald. But picking it up just a minute or two before it will return to the void. I didn't see who picked up the buff. We'll have to see which lane they put it in. Which lane do you think they should put it in here, Crafty?
I feel like it went to the Rumble. Just because he gets to pick which lane he wants to push, and he got a faster pack to get back to the jungle.
Yeah, that is true.
That's kind of why they do it that way, I think. Junglers usually pick it up in the pros. So unless somebody's in like direct pressure to like split push H core.
Yeah, usually just the jungler for the early game. Yeah, as we're seeing Helpme back in the mid lane, Dark Creation forced to flash. He just got back from the fountain. Mo Money actually looks like he should go down here. The package was used by Caboose, and Mo Money does go down. The Cannon Barrage is going out, but it's not going to be enough. Little Tough Guy nowhere to be found. Looks like he had back. This turret is going to take some damage, but Little Tough Guy should get there in time to defend. Clear the minion wave.
Here comes Helpme and TSM are lucky with the flank, though.
Yeah, they're looking to cut them off. The Equalizer goes through the rush, and Toast actually just takes out Little Tough Guy. Never Lucky gets exhausted as Toast repels down. Smilodon TP'd down. The TP from Nubinator as well. Trades going back and forth all over the place. The turret in the mid lane actually did go down. Dark Creation is split pushing, but Never Lucky picks up the kill onto Nubinator. And there it is. Toast goes down as well. Kills going in the favor of almost called them Vicious and Delicious. Team Malicious Intent, that is a 3-for-1 for them. But Dark Creation is split pushing here for Argon 53. He did get the tier 1 turret. The tier 2, it won't be, although it's only more money there to defend. But the rest of Team Malicious Intent are coming. And despite being down 5 kills, Argon 53 are still ahead in gold right now.
Wow, that is surprising. But there are still, they've taken down one tower to zero, I guess. I thought that was going to be more, but yeah. It was just the mid lane tower dropping. They were able to quickly blow up. So they got the Soraka, and so it was 2-for-3, right? Because Soraka died, little tough guy died, and then...
Right, okay.
Because Momani died so quickly.
Yeah, he died at the beginning.
At the very beginning. Yeah. So it was 2-for-3 in the favor of Malicious Intent.
Mm-hmm.
I guess kills and a tower is probably worth in the favor of a Argon 52.
Yeah, you could call that in their favor. Maybe even just call it a wash.
Especially if I guess it wasn't really any of the Yasuo or Corki were able to really pick up kills. They're both 1 and 2 and 1 and 3, so they're not really the farthest ahead. They are ahead in CS in both of their lanes, though.
They are, yeah, by actually a decent amount now. Both ahead by more than 20 at this point. But in that, we had Similodon picking another kill and a couple assists in that fight. The Fate's Call goes in onto Caboose. His support is not there. The bananas and the spears are coming all over the place. The Foss Bomb will not land, and turret aggro being split, Caboose goes down.
And it looks like Lil Tough Guy is caught in the wrong place right now. But
the dredge line and the Riptides going out the barrels are there.
Is he missed one?
I haven't seen him in this one yet. Oh, Lil Tough Guy caught in a bad spot here. The Cannon Barrage not going to come down in time. Oh, it does actually get the kill. My bad. Did not think it was even going to be there. It gets there in time to pick up the kill. A little tough guy just caught out in a bad spot.
That helps Gangplank out quite a bit, as he was quite far behind. Even in CS with the Nautilus's Gangplank isn't really ideal, especially, but when he's 5-3, I would say it probably is. But picking up a kill helps quite a bit. He's already finished the Triforce, looking for probably an Essence Region next for Yomu's.
The chain does not land there for TSM, never lucky. No headbutt either there for Weeblet.
They will be quite good at taking down turrets with the double Triforces. Corki and Elise is also fairly good, Yasuo.
Yeah.
If they can group up, I honestly don't know how that fight would go.
Oh, the dredge line gets windwalled there. He finally missed one, but Dark Creation gets knocked up. The Equalizer comes down as well. There's another kill going over to Similodon. Toast tries to come in with the flank. The Cocoon does not land. The turret goes down. Weeblet pops the Unbreakable Will, but he's not going to be far behind Dark Creation for going down. And Similodon picks it up again. The Dub sitting at 7 kills on this Nautilus right now. And Team Malicious Intent now have taken...
That guy's probably just like, come on, man, give me a kill.
Give me a kill, yeah. Share the love, Similodon. But... You know, he's earning them. It's not like he's just coming in and KSing.
He wanted to take down that former teammate, but Smilodon's still unable to take down the other things one kill was on.
No, he did. He got the double there.
No, I meant Little Tough Guy was unable to take down.
Oh, I see. Oh, yeah, okay. Yeah. I get it. Team Malicious is starting this Baron. Numinator is there to try to sub, but he will just go down. They peel off the Baron, take out Numinator, and although Baron did heal up quite a bit here, this is pretty early, but the Soraka ult comes in to heal them. Toast there now. He gets exhausted. The Fate's Call gonna come in, but he repels up and away. Toast, he is gonna get cut out. Chunked out here. Is it your turn, Caboose, here? Or Argon 53 just gonna take turns walking in and dying
them,
here?
They're keeping them off the Baron. So
they are. And they've chunked them out enough that they're not gonna take it anymore. That was a pretty early Baron attempt here for Team Malicious Intent. And looks like they will back off of it now, able to get chunked out by the Corki, by Toast, and by Numinator. It was a team effort. They did get them off that Baron, but at the price of 2 deaths.
And a full ZC Raw was just picked up by Similodon, so...
Yeah.
Gotta hate that. I
love me some Voidlings.
It helps there that, yeah, exactly. Little Tough Guy able to pick up a couple kills there, and they're... The gold is just still so close. I just don't think Argon 53 will be able to win a 5v5. Just because Nautilus is just too tanky.
Yep.
Rumble Equalizer does so much damage at this point with the Rylai's and the Rune and Geckos completed with the Sword Foods. That's pretty scary. And Kalista obviously
is close.
They just gotta maybe hope that Gangplank becomes that late game threat and can split push. Maybe Yasuo too, runner 1v1.
Oh, Caboose gonna be caught in a bad spot in the Cannon Barrage. Not gonna help. I'm not sure what
that's
he was doing.
That's
there.
A turret that you have to run away from, I think.
Yeah, not worth trying to defend there. The Voidlings are trying to get this top turret here.
Especially when you have no mana, as Caboose was very there, and unable to valk out or anything.
Yeah, just getting caught out and getting farther behind. You're sitting at 5 deaths right now. Has kind of hit with that Triforce. It is kind of at that mid-game power spike. It's doing a lot of damage, but it's only a matter of time before he will be just completely and fully outscaled by a little tough guy on that Kalista, as that bot lane tier 1 turret does finally go down here for Team Malicious Intent, putting them now in the gold lead, getting some global gold from that turret. They're up now about 2k in gold, as well as 10 kills.
Yeah, it just, the only real thing that's keeping Argon 53 would be their CS leads.
Yep.
I'm not really sure what kind of game they want to play to come back here. Maybe just wait another 10 minutes to play, because I don't think they can win a 5v5.
Yeah.
But they can't really give up the Dragons 2 as well, because they've already had 2. I guess it's 2-1. It's not 3-0.
No, 2-1. No, Argon 53 did pick up there first.
Right. The split push, though, will be real out of Nautilus right now. It's very clear that Numinator can't 1v1 him.
No.
There's no way that he's even going to get him low at all.
Yeah, sitting at 7013, definitely Simeledon definitely should be able to 1v1 Numinator. Although Numinator picking up some items, he is going to start doing more damage in these team fights when they start coming up.
The real question is, will they come up?
True.
I think this is going to be a very slow game.
Yeah. Oh, here we go. Simeledon kind of caught in the middle of the team here. He was looking for the follow-up. They're all going in onto him, but he's just so tanky. But he gets knocked over the wall. Numinator getting chunked out the cannon barrage. Not going to hit onto anyone. Simeledon, Riptide's coming out. He's actually getting chunked out fairly little. The Equalizer goes down. Oh, Caboose did try to package up, but got caught by the Dredgeline. This little tough guy picks up the kill onto Toast. Who will be the next to go down? It will be actually Simeledon. He gets shut down finally by Caboose, but Weeblet goes down. Little tough guy finally picking up that kill onto his former bot lane partner. Members of Argon 53 are low here, but with the tower, they should be able to get away from it. And Never Lucky, he's got to be careful. He's getting very low from that tower. 4 members still alive here for Team Malicious Intent, but they are chunked out.
They do have Soraka, though.
They do have Soraka, so just give it a couple seconds here, and they should get back to pretty healthy. But looks like Argon 53 will be able to back. And that,
2-for-1.
Yeah.
They shut down Simeledon. That was huge. He was, like, alive for way too long there.
Yeah, he was just kind of hanging out in the enemy team for, like, 30 seconds.
Just, like,
rip-dying
and auto-people, like... Yeah. How is that possible?
It
was a decent team fight, though, for them. I was surprised how much damage they actually got down, despite Caboose, and I think it might have been... I know Dark Creation was definitely in the middle of everything else,
because
he was ulting in, but...
Argon 53, very healthy here, looking to chase down these unhealthy members of Team Malicious Intent. Gonna see if they can get a pick. Gonna look to land a Cocoon or something, maybe an Alistar
just
combo.
Get this tower here.
Yeah, maybe we'll just take the tower. All 5 members are present, and Team Malicious Intent probably will be best for them to just back off. Argon 53 was able to go back, they were able to back and heal.
If they can stall these backs a little bit longer, they might be able to get another one.
Yeah, and they are able to for a couple members as Simeledon gets caught out here, but again, so tanky, he can kind of do what he can. He can defend this turret almost entirely by himself, as that's a triple knockup, and the Riptides, he's just chunking out all members of Argon 53, but Never Lucky goes over the wall. They're looking to turn this around now. Toast getting caught out. He rappels up and over back onto Grump, but Never Lucky hops over the wall. The Fate's Call comes out, and Lil Tough Guy picks up that kill. Weeblet might be the next one to go down. Knocks him back.
Dodge the dredge line.
Can Simeledon land the dredge line? Oh, he does again! Michael Jordan coming out here. Simeledon is he's like Mike. He got the shoes.
He got the shoes.
He's Lil Bow Wow and like Mike right now. Just landing those dredge lines at max range, but Weeblet still able to escape his former teammate.
The basketball movie references. Next, we need just some Coach Carter in here.
Some Coach Carter, some Martin Lawrence in rebound.
I don't know what else.
There's an obscure one for you. I can't think of any.
Just right with the Queen Latifah and Common.
Yeah, Common, my boy Common. Regular member of the NBA Celebrity All-Star Game. This Baron actually chunking out members of Team Malicious Intent very low. Help me. And TSM Never Lucky are actually just sitting at slivers of health, and they were able to get out of there. Same with Mo Money. These 3 members just got chunked out so low by that Baron.
Yeah, and Cannonbarge even came in on top of him. That would have been a perfect timing
Honestly, could have got a triple kill. Yeah. If they were grouped up enough, you could have got a triple kill there because they were all sitting at just slivers of health. I think
it just came up. It did.
Yeah.
And, definitely a great detour from the Baron, and they're only down 1,200 gold.
That's definitely not a lot.
No, it's definitely not. Well, yeah. Thank you for that.
You're welcome. I know my numbers.
Toast is going in on that repel this time, but no follow through.
Dragon is live.
Are we fighting over Scuttle? No.
No, we're fighting over a dragon. Caboose caught on the wrong side behind enemy lines. The equalizer going to go down. Not going to finish it up. Just kidding. There it is. The burn damage coming in. And Caboose getting caught out once again. And that will be the dragon going over to Team Malicious Intent. Now, they have that numbers advantage. This is dragon number 3 for them.
So what will 5 be at? What? 42?
42, yeah. It's... Yeah, if my math is correct, I believe
let me
that
do the calculations 30
plus 12 is 42.
7 minus 4 is 42.
7 minus 4 is 42.
Yeah.
You're correct!
Thank you!
Just kidding. But that's the second time we've seen Caboose get caught out here, and he really, on this Corki, hasn't had the greatest effect in this game for Argon 53.
No, it has not. But these team fights are just so hard right now, and I think Corki is really strong in general, mm-hmm. especially paired with an Alistar.
Mm-hmm.
And it's not like he's super under farmed or under itemed at this point. Two items is with Sork Boots. Triforce, i.e. Sork Boots, yep. is pretty much all you really your full build.
Yep.
With a package that's full build Corki. So he could still fight, but he's just getting caught up.
Yeah, definitely. All he needs to really do is just sit in the back, throw out the Gatling gun, toss up some Foss bombs, shoot some rockets, and then if he wants, he can use his big old package engage.
That is his package.
Yes, Corki's big old package coming in, kind of the equivalent of Help Me's equalizer. As Toast gets caught out this time, the Dredge Line landing yet again, the Cannon Barrage going down in a choke point for Team Malicious Intent. Not a great spot for them. Weevil goes in with a triple knockup. Unbreakable Will is on, and they are chunking out members of Team Malicious Intent. Mo Money retreating to the back lines. Dark Creation picks up the first kill. Mo Money does go down. There's no ambulance available for Team Malicious Intent. Although Similodon, he's doing some dirty things here to Dark Creation. He does go down, but Nubinator trades one back the other way. Caboose just about full health here, can just take rocks and shoot damage out at the other team, but he's getting chunked out now back
way.
Yeah,
I thought as soon as the package was laid down, you would just lay down the equalizer right on top, and like no teams would, it would just divide the teams. But it didn't happen. It was a pretty late equalizer, actually.
Yeah.
And what was it, 2-for-1 in the end?
2-for-1 for Argon 53, yeah.
And they're actually looking to Baron off this as Help
Me. Oh, but Never Lucky comes back in. Caboose able to Valk out.
Yeah, Help Me is still down for 15 seconds. Mo Money just came back up, and they have an Alistar, so they have the ability to tank this, but I just don't know if they necessarily have the damage. With Gangplank not actually on it, he's just trying to detour some of these members away. They do know they are there with that.
I just don't know if they have enough to do. It looks like they will back off. Nubinator was running interference on the surviving members of Team Malicious
Intent. I think if he goes towards the Baron, just has a couple of barrels ready, then maybe they could have done it, because they're missing quite a bit of damage from him, which really sucks. But now they're just going to do it.
He lands the swag dredge line onto the Baron.
And they know, so they can't necessarily back it. They got chunked. Great equalizer. I mean, Cannon Barrage keeps them off it, and that's pretty worth the cooldown on that. Isn't getting too terrible, and it'll be available by the next fight. Clear the vision back in your favor here.
And is Argon 53 gonna start it again now?
No, kidding. They had the back.
They're just trading starting Baron and then peeling off of it.
Yeah, exactly. So that was definitely a great engage though by Weeblet, I thought. And
here we go.
Dark. This is such a Baron game. I hate this game, but they're not gonna do it. They're just clearing the vision, debating it.
Yeah, debate coming out here. Will they actually start? Though all five members are there.
No pinks on their side definitely doesn't help the fact that they could just easily just ward it back up with sweepers no longer available.
And Weeblet did back, so without that tank there, they are not going to start. A Numinator might actually be caught out by a few members of Team Malicious Intent, but they will back off with three other members coming in to the mid lane now. And will we see a bit of a Tilly going down here, looking for an engage? No one being locked up for either team yet, and they will just back off. And this game is just so even right now. Both teams, gold is even. There's discrepancies in different places. You know, Team Malicious Intent has more dragons. Argon 53 has more towers. CS leads have kind of evened out now as Lil Tough Guy has pulled ahead of Caboose. But Numinator is actually looking to flame Horizon Similodon here, despite how ahead and disgusting Similodon has been in this game.
I don't know why people are always surprised by that. It's a gangplank. You know how easy it is to clear a wave? Like, especially with the waves always being pushing towards them by Similodon, he will be able to pick up so many creeps that are just based on the pushing power from the ZZ. And he'll just go bot, throw three barrels down, clear 40 minions in like 5 seconds, and it'll be like the easiest 40 CS, especially in 35 minutes. But they are going to start the Baron up.
Argo 53.
Here's some vision.
Nautilus
is TPing in on that ward.
Numinator running interference. The Baron was down to below half health, but they will peel off it now. The Equalizer goes down, lands onto a ton of members. Numinator is the first one to go down. The Cannon Barrage is coming. Toast repels up and back down, but he will go down next. Little Tough Guy is there. Similodon,
so
healthy already. Never Lucky picks up the kill onto Weeblet. The flash forward from Similodon lands the short dredge line onto Caboose, and he goes down as well. The double kill for TSM Never Lucky. Dark Creation is the only member of Argon 53 left alive here, and this will be a big push right now for Team Malicious Intent. And we've got the Dignitas Baron throw coming in for Argon 53.
Yeah, that's probably game. I think they can win off this really quickly.
All right.
Death timers are what? They're 20, 15 on Weeblet.
We'll have to see.
They have a decent wave. Nope, they're not going to do it.
They're going to play it safe here. Better safe than sorry, I'm saying.
They don't really have great pushing power, just the Kalista. LeBlanc's terrible at taking towers.
Yeah, not Nautilus, great siege.
Nautilus, Soraka, LeBlanc, Rumble.
Not
too good.
Not very good siege here for Team Malicious Intent. That hopefully they will look to pick up that fourth dragon right now, as it is up to give them reduced damage taken from structures to help their poor siege comp improve it just a little bit. But I think with that team fight now, we can probably say that Team Malicious Intent is decisively in the lead. This game's been pretty even. It's been back and forth, but I'd say right now Team Malicious Intent, they are now in the lead.
Definitely in the lead right now. It was a bit of a risky call to start that Baron.
Yeah.
I don't know if they're definitely in a position to do it, but it ended up not going their way. Great Equalizer on top of the whole team, and not the best Dark Creation ult coming out. He is really doing quite a bit of damage though in these team fights, and if he can end up getting a carry, then maybe a boss bomb.
Here's the engage coming from Similodon, lands the dredge line.
Honestly, this Nautilus is just so gross right now. Look at that. Randuin, Spirit Visage, ZZ Rot, Sunfire, and what the hell is that? Is that gonna last item gonna be like a Warmogs?
Is he
gonna
a Giant's Belt?
That last Giant's Belt, is that gonna be like a Warmogs? Is he gonna have that much more health?
It's definitely a possibility.
Because like Giant's Belt doesn't build into anything with magic resist, so there's.
You also could look for him to pick up the Banner of Command if he wanted to, with the, like we said, not amazing sieging ability on this side here. They might look to pick that up, but looks like they will start the Baron here. All five members are there. Oh, the Cannon Barrage comes down. Gonna peel them off of it, at least for a little bit. Caboose is there tossing rockets, and Never Lucky actually very low. Oh, it was the clone. It was the clone. Don't worry. And that clone with the is back up to about half health, just Soraka things, after being very low. But not going to get that Baron, and let me tell you, Baron is getting a lot of foreplay, but no full action yet, has not gone down. They're tickling her, they're teasing the Baron, but hasn't gone down yet.
The Cannon Barrage detours that so hard though.
Yeah,
it's a big cooldown, but it's worth not even having to fight in there. They don't even have to contest, they just drop a Cannon Barrage, walk away.
Yeah, just
and they all just scatter.
Yeah, they're not necessarily looking for the for the engage, but they're just deterring malicious intent from picking up the Baron. But will they look to go for it again? Still with all five members up, they are going to start it. Argon 53 not very far away, and they're not
doing this. Cannonbarrage is not up.
Yeah, Cannonbarrage not up. They're getting it below half health. Will this be it? Who will be the one to run interference? Toast going to go right in here. Red team does pick it up. That is Team Malicious Intent. Argon 53, they are in a bit of trouble here as Lil Tough Guy picks up one kill. Who will be next? Weeblet knocks back Lil Tough Guy, trying to get that damage source out of the fight. Help me, actually getting chunked up very low. He will go down, but not for the double. The triple is picked up here for Lil Tough Guy. Flashes forward, looking for his former bot lane partner, Weeblet. And looks like it will not be there yet. They will kill this minion wave. And they do pick up the Baron. They pick up three kills. Help me, the only one to go down. This will be the tier 2 mid lane turret. And should be inhibitor turret and inhibitor as well. Or will they just go for game? Who needs the inhibitor turret?
Yeah.
Weeblet and Caboose are still up. The first Nexus turret is down. They're on to the second. Yeah, death timers are still pretty high. The lowest is at 20 seconds. The second one goes down. Weeblet doing what he can, knocking people up all over the place. Looking like Seth Rogen out there. But they're on to the Nexus. Game one goes over to Team Malicious Intent.
GG. That was a great game, I thought. Late TP there by Nubinator, I think, really cost them. No cannon barrage used. I think it came up right there at the end of the fight, and it wasn't used before he died, and it didn't seem like the best time to fight. I'd honestly say they had super minions crashing into their base already.
Yep.
Maybe even just go one person goes for a steal, and then that's about it. Or Alistar, Elise go, and I don't really know, but it ended up going Malicious Intent's way. They picked up the W.
Yep.
Great first win of the series for them. And the matchup, though, is really hype. 40-minute game.
Yeah, 40 minutes. Definitely a long game. And Argon 53, they were trying to play that late scaling. They had the Gangplank. They had the Yasuo. But they weren't able to get ahead really at all in their respective lanes. And while they were definitely in it, they had the damage. And the later the game would have went, the better the chances of Argon 53 would have had. But they just couldn't overcome the kind of mid to early late game damage from coming out from Team Malicious Intent. And they pick up that game one victory.
Yeah, definitely MVP goes to Smilodon on that one.
For sure.
I honestly am surprised he died one time.
Yeah.
I thought he would die zero times.
Well, even before he died, he spent 30 seconds in the middle of the enemy team before he actually went down. So
yeah.
Still impressive.
Very impressive. And just, I think that's something that you have to ban.
I also
like the Shen ban.
Yeah.
I think the Kayle ban is something that you might not need necessarily.
I was reading in chat that Malicious Intent, that TSM Never Lucky likes playing Kayle in the mid lane.
Oh, really?
I read that in Twitch chat.
Is that Dark Creation's like arch nemesis?
Well, you don't want to play Yasuo into Kayle.
No, but there are lots of champions that you can play.
We've only seen Dark Creation play Yasuo and Katarina so far.
True. So
maybe not something that he wants to play against if he really likes that Yasuo. But game one, going over to Team Malicious Intent. We'll have to see if Argon 53 can bounce back in game two. We're going to take a short break here, but stick around.